Muff, we have Cinemax. We don't need to discuss sex.
Sam's right. For once.
With books, the internet,
Lil Kim videos, really educated.
I know, you guys, but the point is there's a lot of information out there, but no guide. Now, Sam, Brooke, I am not going to be one of those parents that lives in denial.
Please be one of those parents.
But I know that this is uncomfortable for you guys. I feel awkward about it, too, but we're going to do it because one of you, and I'm not pointing any fingers, but one of you is thinking about doing it, if not already doing it. Now, I thought that it was bad in my time, you know, the sexual revolution, the pill. But today, it's even worse. I mean, I can't flip on the radio without hearing that new Lollipop song. Be my petting zoo, pet my silky fur.
Is this really happening?
Yeah, I think it is. Jane, I really appreciate your caring, but I pride myself on my judgment.
Yeah, and so do I.
And so did I, girls. But despite that, my first time was horrible. I mean, I knew all about the hype, but I wasn't ready for the emotion. Sex is more than just physicality, you guys. Sex is the ultimate emotional connection, and it doesn't mean a damn unless at the end you want to roll over and talk to that person, you know? Now, unfortunately, I can't teach you about the emotional side of sex. That's learn as you go. But I can get rid of your fears and your worries about the plumbing. So today, I picked up some literature, and I think that it would be super if we can start by reviewing it. Okay, does everyone know the purpose and the origin of the labia majora?
Twice will last the longest in this life. Character or rock hard fight. In the end, do you believe that beauty lies in what you see? 'Cause if you do, then baby, you've been deceived. Well,
Mom, pet me. Met you at the zoo that day. Boy, you were so fine. Despite the smell of animal poop, I wish that you were mine. Oh, baby, baby, the woman that's about it close. So come on, don't be scared. For hours we would pet the beast in their filthy lairs. The stripes are smooth, I felt. But in the dark, I felt the spark and wished you'd pet my pelt.
Be my petting zoo. Silky fur, you don't have to feed me or give me rabies shots. All I require, all I desire.
Do you everything about sex? Yo, my girl Gwyneth and I are on the same page today. Constantly. It's all anyone at school talks about. I know, I feel like this immense pressure to lose it. Yo, she wants to kick it hardcore. Me too. And what's worse is the guys on the team make me feel like I'm such an outsider because I have no experience. Cheerleaders do the same thing. They make me feel like a loser just because I'm the only virgin on the squad. You're a cheerleader. Yeah, I am blonde and very athletic. Sounds like you have no problem finding a guy. Sure, but the right guy is hard. I want someone I can be real with, the way we are. So what do you look like? Tall, dark, built like a quarterback. Maybe we should meet sometime.
Lollipop's number one smash single has single-handedly put me in touch with my own sizzling sexuality.
Oh, Lollipop rocks, and I love cat food.
This Lollipop phenomenon is horrifying. I mean, don't you think it's sending out a completely irresponsible message about sex? I mean, it's like, be promiscuous and you can be cool. I'm taking action, I am passing out condoms.
You can't do that.
Why?
It's against school policy.
Oh, what is that?
What? They were giving out these petting zoo heads at Tower Records as a promotion. I think they're sort of wacky.
Okay, who could ever imagine that this little rubber guy could possibly save my life and yet ruin it?
What happened?
My mom found this in my drawer this morning. So we had the big old birds and bees talk right in front of Brooke. She even included her in it. I was so creeped out.
Sammy, feel your pain at all. But why do you need a condom? Saving up for a rainy day? Well?
Excuse me. Here. Take this. You need it more than she does.
Oh, Sam. Hey, now that we're living together, can you do me a tiny favor?
Please don't leave your wishful thinking sexual aids lying around. Parents always find them, and then there's always the big talk. I mean, you may need it, but it's old hat to me.
What are you insinuating, Brooke, that I need the education? Please, I'm more than informed.
I actually wasn't insinuating anything, other than the fact that you don't have a boyfriend.
You know, I may not have a boyfriend, but at least I don't have an empty relationship.
What is that supposed to mean?
Doesn't take a genius to figure out that you and Josh are the Menudo of couples. Totally interchangeable.
For your information, old maid, we connect on every level. Hey, Sammy, when's the last time you even went out on a date? Not exactly reeling them in, are you?
Trust me, if I wanted to, I could bring home a boyfriend in a second.
Hey, sis. I got this great idea. You out for a little bet?
Lady Luck's firmly on my side.
Great. You have, by the end of the week, to prove to me that you can turn a guy's head and land a boyfriend. And you can't pay for him.
Fabulous. And you have till the end of the week to prove that you and Josh are more than just the jock-slash-cheerleader couple standing on shallow ground.
How am I supposed to prove that?
How about debuting him somewhere other than the football field or your bedroom?
You're on.
Oh!
And to make it worth my while, the loser has to publicly and horrifyingly join knees together.
But that's the abstinence club. Only sexual literates are in that club.
Fitting for you, don't you think?
You're on.
So I've looked it up in the administration guidebook, and all I need is permission from a health administrator, and I can pass out condoms. Can I have your blessing?
Sorry, troublemaker. I'm sucking the mercury right out of your rule-breaking thermometer. See, I've taken the temperature of your little pro-sex plan, and I'm throwing down a big old tub of ice chips.
I am not pro-sex. I'm pro-responsibility. This is insane. Why doesn't the school pass out condoms?
Because that would be promoting sex. If I were to put out a bucket of raincoats on the desk there, guess what happens? I get calls of outrage from very upset parents saying, hey, Nurse Jessie Glass, your job is to throw sawdust on piles of corridor vomit.
Don't you get it? Teenagers are gonna have sex no matter what authority figures say. If you won't let me pass out condoms, what are the alternatives here?
I say do what works for me. Stay home on Friday nights, pet the cats, and watch Providence. Be very clear on this, miss. If I catch you distributing sausage wrappers in my school, your disrespectful little booty is gonna get cramps from a long spell in detention.
So you smoothed out a few of the rough edges. Big deal. When you guys were in the chat room, did you hit on something real?
Yeah, man, like Jada and Will.
Well, then you gotta meet her, because everything else is just superficial crap. I mean, why do you think Brooke and I have lasted so long?
Dude, because you both look like models.
No, it's because we have that connection. When you connect, sugar, it's all that matters. Right?
Yeah.
All right, I'll see.
Hey, Sammy, when's the last time you even went out on a date? Not exactly reeling them in, are you?
Leo, what are you doing here?
Here's the 411 nosy butt face. Leo here's a broke dreamer looking for direction in his life. And to make money until he finds his way, he's offering tennis lessons. Any sport with love in it is a sport at which he excels. Got it?
We can't wait to smack your tennis balls around on the court, Leo.
Hey, Sammy. You should really sign up. With an experienced teacher, it's totally painless.
Kind of busy now, you know?
Think about it. A little exercise does a body good.
Wish I had a photograph of everyone I knew.
Who do you think you're fooling? He's not gonna date a sophomore.
The pictures on the windowsills and mirrors in my room would celebrate the life in every.
Guess who I've been on the phone with for the past hour?
The crusading spirit of Gandhi.
No. The president of Everybody's Doing It Condoms. He offered up what I asked for. Over 1,000 love gloves to distribute at my discretion.
Finally, activism I can support. But Lil, you know you're gonna get detention.
Not if I'm clever and resourceful. That's how you beat the system. Mm. Hey, you do magic tricks, right?
Why?
Harm? Honey, what's wrong?
She watched Sleepless in Seattle again this morning.
So, Subi, if I want a little mystery and Maggie romance.
You know what's a mystery to me? Chicks. I hang out with them. I love them. I just never get them. I mean, what is it? Am I so horrifying to look at?
No.
Once in a while I get zits and stuff, but I'm still a good guy.
Maybe you're just trying too hard. I just think that girls want guys not so available. It's sick, but true.
You know, Sammy, that's really great advice, but if you're so knowledgeable about sex and romance, why aren't you out there putting yourself out and getting a boyfriend?
You're right. You're absolutely right, Harrison. If I want a boyfriend, I'll just have to sign up for one. Excuse me.
Wait, are they giving them away somewhere?
Hey, Josh.
Hey, what's up, babe?
Listen, I don't think we're connecting, but I think I have an idea how we can. I always suspected you're a part camel.
I worked out, Brooke.
You know, you should try a little exercise.
Other than your empty Thighmaster presses in the backseat of Josh's car.
Hey, girls.
Jane, are you and Daddy busy on Friday night?
Here.
Thanks. No, I don't think so. Why?
Well, I thought it'd be nice to have Josh over for dinner. You know, my boyfriend. I mean, we talked about it, and he really wants to come over and become part of the family. You know, communicate, discuss world events, bond, pretty much.
Oh, well, that's great. That's great. Sam, you busy Friday night?
Mm-hmm. Actually, Mom, I am busy. Got a date.
You're dating someone? Oh. Who's the mystery man?
You know, why don't I see if I can jiggle our schedules around for Friday night so you can meet him? We'll join you for dinner, Brooke. Sounds like a blast.
Time for Sugar D to get real and connect. The
Let's do it. Let's meet. How about tonight?
Knees together. It's all about abstinence. The only way to prevent the misery that walks hand in hand with knocking boots. Who's with me?
This petting zoo promotion rocks.
Have sex with it.
It's a poodle.
Yes. Have sex with it.
Get your petting zoo balloons!
What are you doing here?
These are part of a lollipop promotion. I am the president of the Kennedy High Lollipop Fan Club.
Look, you're pretty smart here, don't you, sister? These are not petting zoo balloons. These are condoms, sculpted into toys in a transparent attempt to skirt regulations.
Oh! Wow, neat. Do you guys do birthday parties too?
You do realize, of course, that condoms have other uses?
Wow, Nicole, I'm impressed. You recognize these as condoms while totally sober.
Let me give you a little bit of advice. Girl to stick figure. Endorse something you know a little bit about. If you're looking for a worthy cause, may I suggest breast implants? Your boyish figure is absolutely chilling.
Mr. John, Miss Esposito, you're going down.
Does this make any sense to you?
I guess. Actually, not really, Brooke. Look, I think our relationship is going great. I think you don't need to necessarily talk to somebody all the time to communicate, you know? I think it's cool that I found someone I can hold hands with in silence sometimes. You may find it freaky, but I find it comforting.
Josh, what I'm trying to say is that I think that there's something deeper lacking here. I need to feel rooted with you and communicate, not only physically, but on all kinds of levels, mentally, spiritually. Josh, I want you to be my family, and to do that, you need to be a part of it.
Well, I want to make this work. So I'm coming to the dinner.
Great. Great. Okay, we've got a few hours before we dine with the fam. Let's prepare for reviewing the current events conversation connection guide I made for you. Number one.
Hey, Brooke, Jane, Mr. McQueen, Sam. How about that Kosovo situation? Crazy, huh?
One more time.
This is the most whack detention I've ever heard of.
Nah, it makes sense. She knows if she put us in regular study hall detention, we just pass out spermicides. I hate Nicole.
Stupid Lil, you're not boyish.
Yeah? Then how else do you explain my perpetual singleness?
Could it be your intensity and constant crusading create a wall that keeps guys out? I wonder.
Look, I'm not exactly the guy you should be asking about your romantic problems. I'm perpetual single dude, remember?
God, why can't this whole sexual initiation thing be as easy as talking to you?
I know. A relief that would be. If you could remove the emotional uncertainty from the equation and not feel you were going to be judged.
Is this possible?
Maybe. If you skip the whining and dining and went straight to friendship, isn't that where relationships lead anyway?
So, if an activist and her activist in training...
That would be me, yeah.
We're curious and wanted to see what sex would be like.
Then they should choose a first-time partner who's a...
A friend.
I'm not doing anything tonight. Are you?
Let's review a few of the basics. Starting with your backhand. Okay? That's good. Okay? That's good, Sam. And just let it flip. Back and forth. back and forth.
So have you heard that new lollipop song?
Who hasn't at this point? Sex in the air, huh? Remember back in the day, the pressures to do it were huge. All right, now bend your knees a little bit. Good.
So when did you...
lose my innocence?
Mm-hmm.
I was your age. Lost it right here on this court.
How was it?
It was great. Hot. We had candles and rose petals and pillows. It was a total Marrakesh experience. Never forget your first time.
Are you doing anything for dinner? You want to grab a bite?
I'm sorry, Sammy. I can't. I'm going out with a few of my college dropout buds. Yes. Let's practice some lunges. Sam, you okay?
Oh, I think I sprained my ankle.
Should I call the ambulance?
No, I just need to get home.
Well, how are you gonna do that if you can't walk?
I just want to say how great it is eating as a family.
I agree. This hummus rocks, Miss McPherson.
Thanks.
Where is Sam?
Maybe she got tied up at the newspaper.
Maybe she's still looking for a boyfriend. Boy, am I hungry. Let's eat.
Dress, is it new?
Yes, it is. I bought it yesterday. I haven't had a chance to wear it yet.
You know, Leo, it's been so long since I've seen you. Are you sure you can't stay for dinner?
Oh, I.
Well, it does smell good. And any time I get to spend with Sam is cool. So, I'd love to. If it's okay with you, Sam.
Absolutely.
Well, that's great. Okay. Let's begin.
So, Leo, how long have you and Sammy been going out? It's just so exciting.
Well, 2 days. We're, a young romance.
So you two are...
We've known each other a long time from back in the day when we used to play Batman together. Remember that?
Oh, gosh. Sam, I don't mean to be vulgar, but aren't you a little worried about your and Leo's age difference? I mean, there is the whole generation gap, not to mention, Leo, the jailbait problem. Jane.
I think I speak for Jane and myself when I... Exactly how old are you, Leo?
Well, sir, old enough to know that I have to act responsibly.
So, Josh, is this your first time here?
No, Sam, I've been here lots of times.
No, I mean, in a room without pillows.
So, how about that Kosovo thing going on over there? Crazy, huh?
I'll be carrying a lime green bag.
Great.
And I will be in a silver tie.
Fake? Virgin? Can you pay for the room? There you go.
Bye, Brooke. Mom? Mike?
You have a curfew, young lady.
I know.
Should I, carry you back?
Oh, no, I think the swelling's gone down.
Well, her swelling may have gone down, but you know that his is just beginning.
Janie, where are you going?
I'm going to the store to buy some after-dinner mints. What do you think? Where do you think I'm going? I'm going to stop them.
We trust our daughters, remember?
No, I don't on this issue. I don't trust her, and I never will. I don't trust her because I was her once.
And you didn't listen to a word your parents had to say on the topic?
It's so hard.
Nobody ever said it was going to be easy.
So, tonight went okay, I think. What are you thinking?
I'm, thinking that maybe we're going about this the wrong way. I think maybe to achieve real intimacy, we need to have real intimacy. I'm late. I was experimenting with non-boyish hairstyles.
It paid off.
Can I come in?
Right. Sorry. See, I know you. This is supposed to be easy.
Uh-huh. Okay. Harrison.
Something to drink? I know you like Jamba Juice, so I just bought it all. Aloha Pineapple, Razzmatazz.
I've always been a sucker for peach pleasure. Ah.
A toast.
Okay.
To feeling incredibly awkward here.
Yeah, I'll drink to that. You know what I've always wanted to say? I think I should slip into something more comfortable.
You've done this before, haven't you?
Oh, it's flannel, pajamas.
I thought you usually slept in those slinky silk numbers. That's what you've usually worn.
Before. Yeah, I know. I wore those because I was trying hard. I think from now on, we should just be how we really are and not work at it so much.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm nervous. After all this waiting, I'm totally terrified.
Why?
Because I've never felt closer to anybody in my life than I do to you. Do you feel that way too?
I want to. That's why we're here.
Miss McPherson.
Yes?
May I kiss you?
I was hoping for a little lower than that.
Yeah, I know. That's what we need to talk about. There was something going on with you and Brooke tonight at the dinner table.
We had this bet. She had to prove that her relationship was more than physical, and I had to prove that...
that you could get a boyfriend. You can, Sam. It just can't be me. At least not until we move beyond this whole jailbait thing. I mean, I dig on you now. The next thing I know, I'm in county lockup. I lied to you about losing my virginity.
You did it in the back seat of a car.
Nope, here. But there were no pillows, rose petals, or candles. Just a blanket and two people that got it on before they even knew each other's last names. Look, the thing is, relationships have to develop naturally. You force one, it's doomed from the start.
Harrison, I'm sorry. I can't do this.
What? Say that again.
I don't know. In theory, it all made sense, but you were right about me. They do put up walls. And the problem is, on the other side of the wall, I see a friend.
Yeah, well, then that's why we're here, right?
Yeah, but it's also why we can't go through with this. You're my friend.
And you're worried sex might ruin that?
No. I mean, that's how I look at you.
You're not attracted to me?
If you're honest with yourself, you'll realize that that's how you feel about me, too.
Totally. Yeah, I think you may be right. I mean, yeah, definitely.
I know that there's somebody out there for you, for both of us, and don't you think it's better if we wait for the right person?
Yeah, absolutely.
Can we just, go to the diner and grab a plate of curly fries? My treat?
Nah. Yeah, I should clean up, check out, that sort of thing.
So if we're meant to be together, fate will. Josh.
Steve, can we wrap? Okay, this is hard. Lime green purse, silver tie. It's me, I'm Gwyneth 2187.
Yo, why are you playing me?
I'm not. I just wanted to explain and look. I know that I shouldn't have stood you up. I just didn't want to embarrass both of us. But then I realized, well, I feel horrible because I know I would have been really hurt, and I'm sorry.
Yo, why are you making this harder? Don't you think I wish that I could have been that guy? Do you know how hard it was for me to even show up? Knowing that I was gonna be found out?
It was hard for me to show up, too. And what's so stupid is I keep thinking that I'm beyond this point. I mean, are we really that bad off that we need to pretend to be people that we're not?
I think us people pretend.
DeKid and Gwyneth kept it real.
Yeah. Yeah.
And there's no reason why they can't still be friends and keep it real online.
That'd be tight, Carmen.
Can I have a chip? Thanks.
You gonna eat that apple? I decided to leave vegetarianism behind. I'm gonna be a fruititarian.
Where do you think up this stuff?
I don't know. Like, I forgot to tell you something the other night. You have really fabulous teeth.
I just don't understand what I did wrong.
You didn't do anything wrong. Joshy, you're not wrong. I'm not wrong. It's just that I thought finally doing it, getting as intimate as we could physically, would maybe fix all the other stuff. But after we did it and you fell asleep,
so what you're saying is I failed. I'm the one who dropped the ball. I'm the one who doesn't connect as deep as I should. Well, you're wrong, Brooke. God, you're so wrong.
Josh, just because we're breaking up doesn't mean that we still can't be friends.
I love you, Brooke. You're the first thing I think about in the morning, and you're the last thing I see at night. I've waited for you. The other night wasn't sleazy. And I didn't leave. I mean, I shared with you the most precious thing that there is. And I'm sorry you didn't feel connected. Because in that moment, lying there and loving you, I've never felt more connected to anybody in my whole life.
Rub it in.
Brooke, I come in peace. Also to tell you that I didn't win. Without going into all the gory details, I was shot down. I tried to force something that wasn't there.
Stings like hell when that happens.
Yeah. So I guess we both lost.
Yeah. I guess we did. Hey, Sam. Living life shouldn't be about rushing into something. Because at the end of the day, you were smart to wait. You only get one first time. Make sure it's worth it.
Knees together. It's all about abstinence. The only way to prevent the misery that walks hand in hand with knockin' boots. Who's with me?